If there is any good that has emerged from the ashes of the Super League, it is the scrutiny and pressure that has been mounted on the rich men who are behind it all. In the case of Arsenal Football Club, that man is Stan Kroenke. Amongst the majority of the Arsenal fanbase, Kroenke was already out of favor. However, after the Super League fiasco, Kroenke has gone from a man out of favor to a man who is detested amongst the Arsenal fanbase. Kroenke, a man who doesn't attend games, doesn't feel the pulse of the club, and doesn't seem to have the capabilities to put a stop to Arsenal's recent decline, is a man who is now under immense pressure. Arsenal's poor result on Friday was overshadowed by the protests and unity displayed by fans before the Everton game. Arsenal fans from all over are now united by one common message: Kroenke out. Friday was a calling to Arsenal fans all over the world, all of whom who are desperate to play a role in changing the club's fortunes for the future. However, there was one Arsenal fan who stood above the rest, one with the finances and capabilities of truly changing the future of Arsenal Football Club. So, without further ado, meet Daniel Ek, the billionaire Arsenal fan who may very well be on his way to save Arsenal Football Club. According to recent reports, Daniel Ek, the founder of Spotify, is preparing a takeover bid for Arsenal. Although Josh Kroenke, the son of Stan and director at Arsenal, has insisted his family are not looking to sell the club, sources believe they could be tempted by a bid of around £2 billion. On Friday night, Ek announced his initial interest in buying Arsenal, with a message on Twitter that read, "As a kid growing up, I've cheered for Arsenal for as long as I can remember. If KSC would like to sell Arsenal, I'd be happy to throw my hat in the ring." Moreover, on Monday morning, further reports revealed that Ek is working with Thierry Henry, Dennis Bergkamp, and Patrick Vieira, three of Arsenal's greatest ever players, on a bid to take control of the Gunners. The involvement of Henry, Bergkamp, and Vieira will generate huge public support for the group, adding to the weight of pressure building on the Kroenke family to sell the club. If Ek is successful, it is understood that Henry, Bergkamp, and Vieira could all return to Arsenal as part of the new setup, with their knowledge of the club and the fanbase already proving invaluable to takeover plans. But firstly, who is Daniel Ek, and how did he make his money? Daniel Ek is a Swedish billionaire entrepreneur who is estimated to have a net worth of around £3.4 billion. The 38-year-old is the co-founder and CEO of music streaming service Spotify, which is valued at over £52 billion. Ek's taste for business was apparent from an early age. At just 13 years of age, he started to build websites for businesses. In school, he used to bribe fellow classmates with video games for their help in website development. At the age of 18, he had a team of 25 people working for him, and at the age of 23, he sold his online marketing company, Advertigo, for more than $1 million. After taking a brief break from business, in 2006, Ek founded Spotify, along with Martin Lorenzon. Just 11 years later, Ek was named the most powerful person in the music business. And according to Forbes, he first became a billionaire in 2019, a year after Spotify went public. Now, at the age of 38, Ek is looking to explore other business interests. However, the Swedish entrepreneur never expected an opportunity to buy his boyhood club, all up until last week. Daniel Ek was 21 years old when Arsenal created modern football history by winning the Premier League title while finishing the 03-04 season unbeaten. Like all Arsenal fans of that generation, the Swedishman grew up idolizing the likes of Thierry Henry, Dennis Bergkamp, and Patrick Vieira. So, it stands to reason that when Ek decided he was serious about trying to buy Arsenal and restore the club's former glory, that he would tap into the knowledge of some of the club's greatest ever players. But, other than being legends of the club and heroes of the Arsenal faithful, Henry, Bergkamp, and Vieira all bring a unique skill set and knowledge to the table for Ek to tap into. Thierry Henry, now aged 43, is arguably the Premier League's greatest ever player. However, he is much more than just a figurehead for Ek's takeover. The Frenchman has played under three of the most influential managers of the past three decades: Arsene Wenger, Pep Guardiola, and Gerard Houllier. He has inner knowledge of the workings of both Arsenal and Barcelona at the peak of their powers. Henry also worked as a player within the hugely successful Red Bull franchise in New York, and has already amassed a wealth of coaching experience in his three jobs with the Belgium national team, Monaco, and most recently at the Montreal Impact in the MLS. His understanding of the management side, as well as the business components of the game, will prove invaluable to ex-takeover plans. Rewind 10 years and Bergkamp was part of Johan Cruyff's reinvention of Ajax that involved the return and promotion of a number of club legends, including Bergkamp himself. Cruyff's revolution included the return and promotion of former players, such as Bergkamp, Frank de Boer, Mark Overmars, and Edwin van der Sar. At Ajax, it did not take long for the plan to succeed, as, having gone 7 years without winning a title, Ajax won 4 successive league titles and started to produce some of the best talents in the world. During his time at Ajax, Bergkamp worked in a variety of roles before eventually leaving Ajax 4 years ago. Originally, the Dutchman had started with the youth team until he became an assistant under Frank de Boer and eventually Peter Bosch. Bergkamp has been credited with a lot of the recent success associated with the Ajax Academy, and it was anticipated that if he returns to Arsenal as part of ex-takeover plans, it would most likely be in the form of an academy role. Last but not least, Patrick Vieira is the final component of ex-takeover team. Like Henry and Bergkamp, Vieira, who has played for AC Milan, Inter Milan, Juventus, as well as Arsenal, has a wealth of playing experience to call upon, and has played for some of the game's top managers. However, it is understood that it was Vieira's time at Manchester City while working for the City Football Group that may be the most use to ex-takeover plans. During his time at City, Vieira took the job of football development executive and was in charge of youth development. Vieira oversaw the academy for multiple years before moving on to a coaching role with New York City FC in the MLS, before leaving in 2018 to take charge of Ligue 1 club Nice. With Henry, Bergkamp, and Vieira, Ek has put together a formidable team, who both understand the club and have worked in a variety of different positions in the footballing world. As Henry said in an interview earlier this week, "I do not recognize my club anymore." Perhaps, Thierry, it's time for a grand return. Alongside your invincible teammates, Bergkamp and Vieira, partnered with Daniel Ek, a super team has been formed. One in which, with the plans to save Arsenal Football Club.